Remi, in the past few years, we've seen lumber prices go around the world, if you will. Let's talk about softwood lumber prices, pulp prices. Tell us, where are they at right now?
Well, what we've seen, as you pointed out, is a significant increase in lumber prices in the last several years after a decade post-financial crisis, where prices were significantly weaker. So in the last few years, due to increased building activity, due to demand related to repair and remodel, we saw a significant price increases in lumber. In the last several weeks, prices have come down a little bit as mortgage rates have risen. And the home building activity remains strong, but a little bit more questions about activity and transactions. So lumber has come off a little bit. But I think if you looked at prices and where they were today from a historical perspective, you would see that they remain fairly strong. We are constructive on lumber outlook for several years to come, just based on the underlying factors and macroeconomic factors that are driving it.
I was going to save this for near the end, that outlook question, but mm-hmm. you're bringing it up right now. Rising interest rates, home mm-hmm. prices are falling. How do you think about construction? You mentioned some of the macro and I guess some of the underlying currents that are giving it an optimistic outlook for the forestry industry. But give us from your vantage point specifically what you see mm-hmm. happening.
Well, what we see is that after the financial crisis of 2008-2009, there was about a decade of underbuilding. And the reality is that when you look at the history of home requirements and home building formations, household formations, it just wasn't sustainable to have housing starts in the low million. And so somewhere around 1.5 is consistent with the post-war average since World War II. And that's kind of, we're above that now. But what happened is post-pandemic, there was, due to the underbuilding for a decade, there was a gap that was created. And we saw that the market was underbuilt and we're catching up now. That's a big part of what explains the rise that we saw in lumber prices in the last couple of years. And we think just with demographic factors, millennials are now entering into their prime home buying years. And so that's why we remain constructive on lumber for some time to come.
Let's talk about the catching up issue and whether or not supply chains have worked themselves out specifically when it comes to your industry.
Well, we at the end of the first quarter, we had a significant increase in inventory, in particular in lumber. I think it was a well-reported challenge that the railroads had following the pandemic and the winter that we had. So our inventory in particular at the end of the first quarter was almost double what we would have wanted it to be for lumber. Things have improved a little bit. We're not going to bring it back to normal at the end of this quarter, but we think that over the course of the year, it should come back to normal. But the reality is that, a supply chain is a very sophisticated thing. It has many moving parts, and it takes some time for things to adjust. The railroad system doesn't have sprint capacity to get out from some of its challenges. So we've said at the end of last quarter that would take through the end of this year for things to get back to normal, and we're making progress in that direction.
And of course, things will change for quarters to come for Resolute.
Yes.
You recently were acquired by Paper Excellence. What is it about your business do you think that made you attractive to a company like Paper Excellence?
Well, we think that, what we announced yesterday was that we had entered into an agreement to be acquired by Paper Excellence. We think it could take up to a year for the transaction to close. What makes us, I think, attractive for them is the opportunity to grow. They're a company, they acquired Domtar last year in a $3 billion transaction. They want to continue to grow. The reality is that Resolute offers them complementary assets to the assets that they have in terms of pulp packaging and paper. We bring our own lumber tissue businesses and pulp, paper and pulp businesses as well. So it makes for growth opportunities for them. We think that we've come a long way as a business in the last few years to strengthen our core business, how we operate, what we do. And we think that we've also done a great job at defining our growth strategy. And I think that when Paper Excellence looked at that, they realized that we've got a great business here and there's opportunity for more growth. And from Resolute's perspective, what the transaction does is that we think it accelerates our opportunities for growth because it's going to give us access to tools, capital, and opportunities we might not have had on our own. And so that's why I think it's an exciting development for the company.
You paint a very optimistic picture, but of course, we have used words like inflation and, of course, recession. How do you think about those narratives when it comes to the sector?
Well, and we saw in the first quarter, we saw energy prices significantly higher. And so that had an impact on us. In our case, we were able to make it up with better pricing. But for sure, there's a lot of questions about the assumptions that we take on the horizon as we develop our financial models to determine what our steps should be. But if you look at things on a long-term perspective, we think we're still we're very optimistic about the business that we have and the opportunities for growth. And we think that the Canadian forest product sector is a very resilient one. It's had a very good couple of years, which is a very positive development after the difficult decade following the financial crisis.
Where do we stand when it comes to trade, specifically our neighbors to the south and the duties on Canadian softwood lumber? Where does that stand right now?
Well, it's not making a lot of progress is the reality. It's something that we were hoping would progress after the election of President Biden. We were hoping for a change in tone. But it hasn't really moved. There hasn't been, we think, the political will on the U.S. side to advance the issue. We work closely with the government of Canada, and I know that they are focused on the issue. But as far as we know, there really hasn't been any material development to move it forward in the last couple of years.
Going forward, do you see, your fundamental business model changing at all? Is there a difference between the lumber market versus paper?
Well, what we see is an ability to take a longer term view as we become a private company after the transaction closes. It's going to give us an ability to look further down the path and look at projects we might not have had the opportunity to do on our own. But otherwise, I don't think it really changes the business that we have. The commitment that Paper Excellence has taken is to operate Resolute as a standalone company and to explicitly back our growth strategy that we've already outlined, which was focused on strategic investments in our pulp business and our lumber businesses. And those are going to continue and also to focus on maximizing the value of our paper assets and our tissue business. So I don't see any material change in the business strategy. But as I said, it will unlock opportunities that we didn't have on our own.